Hey guys, welcome back. In today's video, we're gonna paint the rest of this painting here, the jungle part and the tiger. So we're starting with the palette like I have here in front of me for mixing the colors. Now for the second layer, for the jungle in the back, as you can see here, I'm mixing quickly some colors that enable me to basically build up the layers of color fitting to the background color, more or less. So I have to basically freestyle the colors, more or less. Trying to match them with the background colors. And as I try to really let those things, those tree details emerge from the background, we basically remix, at least in the background, the colors for the background, from the clouds. And then I step further to the front and try to build up more details using lighter colors. As you can see here, we have the sun coming in from above and this needs to be represented. And we also use a lot of those purplish, bluish, colder, greenish colors. And this kind of a freestyle approach. Just trying to really connect the background with the foreground, but also have some nice little color difference. This is also applied for the water I'm painting here, the waterfall. The color of the shadow is determined by the color of the sky, and in this case we have basically a warm color and a cold color, and the shadow here is determined, or is the color here is determined by the color that we have in the colder areas of the sky, and therefore I have to repeat this purplish color from the sky on those shadow areas of the water that we have here. And this really helps to make this thing look realistic and how can I put it? Use the color from the sky, in this case the cold one, and build it up on the water, and then you will have a waterfall that looks nice and realistic. Another trick I'm using here is I mix the color from the background and basically poke holes in it into the front part, as you can see here, so that we have parts where we have the background apparently shining through. And this is a very, I think this is the easiest way of building up details. Basically you put in the color first, the darker one, and then you poke in holes from the with the color from the background, and this will really, this process makes it much easier and much more controlled, and especially much quicker. And the rest of the leaves here and the tree details is basically more or less hinted. It looks way more detailed than it really is. I achieved this by just adding some colors on top of the dry color, the layer of color that we put in before. And not in all places, not everywhere. And this really communicates a lot of detail that we have here that is not there, basically. So you don't need to really paint every single leaf or tree detail or whatever. Just hint them here and there. And with this technique, you basically have a lot more details coming in that you don't just need to paint. Adding some branches here and there, basically adding some details in strategic places that again also add up to the highly detailed area that we on the view to believe that we have here, but that we actually do not have, more or less. A very important part here is that you put a lot of effort into the areas that basically overlap on the edge. And that's what I do here now. Basically, I add a ton of details, ton of leaves on the edge. And along with this way of building up the details on the outer part, you get the impression of a lot of more details that there are than we have in reality. I also rework color patches here and there, adding some darker areas with a bit of a bigger brush in a very blended way to get more depth into this whole thing here and there. And also note that the color is thinned down quite a bit on the edge. Not in all the places, but some areas need to really have a very thin layer of color so that the color that we apply here really connects with the background. See this especially on the upper part here, where I basically here now use the dry brush technique to connect those two layers that we have here. The layer of the trees and the layer of the sky in the back. And again, I'm putting on details over the dry areas here. And I try to include as many forms as we possibly can have in a jungle. As you can see here, again, some branches here and there, some bit more details here and there. And it didn't took too long to really build up very quick. Apparently a ton of detail that we just don't have to paint. I also had to connect the background a bit more with the area here and there. Yeah, and therefore I started to remix the color from the background and connect the jungle part with this again. You know, you see how I build up the detail on the rocks in the front part here. It's basically again a dry brush technique, dry blending technique that I use here. This also helps in adding not just detail but also depth to the whole thing. And you have the layer from the first pass shining through. This really makes it look more realistic. Yeah, and then we finally start to paint the tigers, and I have to admit, this is, I think, the second or third tiger that I ever painted. And although this is a very small part of the painting, it took forever to get this thing painted, because you have to add so many details. And I also learned that a tiger is basically like painting a portrait. If you do something wrong, it looks off, and you will really ask yourself, what the heck is going on? Why is it looking so bad? And therefore, I later on do rework the whole thing, the face of the big one, especially, again and again, in areas, small details that need to be changed to make it just look better. The rest is basically more or less straightforward. But keep in mind that you need to adjust the colors when you paint. I used some reference here that where the light was not like the light situation we have here in this painting. I didn't have this cold color from the sky basically kicking in to the shadow areas. And therefore I had to make sure that I get those colors in. Basically, this lighter color on the left area, this warm color, lighting up especially on the ear part. As you can see here, we have very, very light color coming in. And the white hair of his face on the right side is basically, again, a repetition of the color of the water and the sky in the cold areas. And this, only when you do this, the whole thing starts to look realistic. Basically, the warm color on the left side, where the sun hits, where we have the light from the sun coming in, and the colder, darker color on the right side, that needs to be put in. And you don't see this on the reference material. You just need to be aware of those laws of physics to make a painting, yeah, basically straight from your imagination. Not really straight, but the light situation, basically. Yeah, this is very important to learn on this part of the painting here. The stripes, just a tip for the stripes, make them follow the line of the body of the tiger. This sounds obvious, but if they don't follow the line, they look completely off. Yeah, I will show you now the rest in a time lapse so that you get a better grasp of what's going on here. Again, we have this dark purplish grayish color in the shadow areas for the whiter fur that we have here. And yeah, the fur details basically are just hinted on this scale. We have the tiger here, and we can't paint every single hair. This is impossible, but we need to hint these details. And therefore, I you see it here now, hinted those fuzzy hair things on his darker areas on his front. And when you step a few feet away, this really adds up and becomes realistic looking hair. Just a trick to really make it look more realistic in a very easy way. Now to the cup, and he basically repeats the whole story again. And you see, I also had to add those lighter areas on his right part, where the sun basically comes in, and this is not that visible, not that strong popping out of the painting. But if you don't do this, the small cup here would look off and wrong. So always be aware of the light situation that you have here. Make it really. I mean, it's not a photorealistic painting, yeah. It's realism, but still make sure that you repeat the color scheme that you have on your overall base color reference that you're using. So, that's it again for today, but before you leave, make sure you check out one of these other two videos here.